Hi, this is a short video about my new homemade slot mortising machine. I'll show you how. I shot that video 4 years ago and I've gotten much better at making videos since, so I thought I'd make another video on this slot mortiser. The machine has this XY sliding action, and the sliding for this is actually using modified drawer slides. This one is a center drawer slide. For this one I use keyboard drawer slides, but really any non-telescoping type of slide can be used. That is, a slide that's two parts. The telescoping variety, like this one, tends to have too much play in them, so they're not really suitable. You can't really see the slides in the machine because I added these rails everywhere to really cover it up to keep them away from the dust. For vertical adjustment, I have a 5/8 inch polished steel rod and bronze bushings, and I've got a threaded rod here for cranking the rudder up and down. To keep this crank from moving from vibrations, I added a detent mechanism in here using just a hex nut and this piece of steel that pushes against it. And also, to count how many times I've turned this crank if I'm making multiple cuts, I added a wheel that counts the number of turns. The wheel gets advanced by a pin that sticks out the bottom of the crank. And every time that goes past the wheel, it grabs one notch and moves it. So as long as the crank is not against the wheel, I can take that wheel and change where my zero position is. That sort of thing comes in very handy if I need to make a multiple mortise joint. And I've got the scale marked on here. I've got 32 teeth on the wheel, 16 threads per inch on the threaded rod, so two full turns of this wheel is 2 inches of vertical adjustment on the router. I've also got stops that can be adjusted, which limit how far the router can move side to side. And I just move that against where I want it to be and just tighten this knob, and that acts as a stop. I've also got a depth stop along the side here for limiting how far this will plunge into the wood. And I added a backstop as well because sometimes I want to use this as a horizontal router table. So just by moving the stops against each other, I can lock the router in place. For attaching stock to the table, probably the quickest is to just put a clamp in a slot in the table, like this. But I've also got this funny sort of clamp. This is a adjustable C-clamp that I got on clearance, and it fits in here. And the cool thing is, it sort of locks onto the table. So this clamp stays put in place. Another option is to just put a bolt in the table and then use this drill press clamp, and that holds the stock very firmly in place, but it doesn't have a huge opening. So another option would be to use something like my homemade clamp that I made for my pantry loader, which has quite a lot of reach, and I have blocks for raising and lowering to give quite a lot of adjustment. But this machine can do more than just cut mortises, so I'll demonstrate by cutting a finger joint into the end of a piece of 2x4. So thanks to the stationary table, there's no limit to how large a piece of stock I can cut with this machine. The thing that this machine doesn't do is put round edges on the tenon, which is why I invented my Pantarotor machine. But my favorite type of joint with this machine has to be putting lots and lots of mortises side by side. So that type of joint just makes for loads and loads of joint area, which makes for super strong joints. A few years after I built this machine, I invented my Pantarotor machine, and this machine can do everything that this can do, and then some, using templates. So with this machine, with the right kind of template, I can do mortises, or finger joints, or dovetail joints, or tenons, or even plantation shutters. So some have asked if the Pantarotor makes my slot mortiser obsolete, because with these templates you can do a lot of joints. But the advantage of this machine is it doesn't need templates, so for any sort of joint that this machine can do, it's much quicker to set it up.